Background gradients are magical. You can use them on their own or even on top of an existing background color or image. But first, let's clear up a couple things. Number one, the verb is gradate, not gradiate. And number two, when we're talking about stops, we're talking about the set points along the gradient from which colors fade from one to another. And we're going to cover two types of gradients we can use in our projects, linear gradients and radial gradients. Let's start with linear. And here on the page, we have a section which already has a background image and some content inside. Let's select the section because this is what we want to start styling. If we go down and add a gradient, we see our default black and white stops. Before we make any changes to those, let's click around to see what some of the angle directions do, and we can even grab our angle dial and drag to adjust with some more precision. Or if we're really fans of extreme control, we can type in an angle and press enter. Double-clicking a stop gets us access to the color picker. From here, of course, we can change the color on this stop as well as the opacity. And as we adjust the opacity, the background image becomes visible again. Let's click out. At any time, we can add additional stops by clicking underneath the gradient preview. And we can adjust these stop positions by clicking and dragging on any of them. And to remove, just drag the stop down and out. We also have an option to reverse the stops, and it does just that. It reverses the order of the stops. If we move the rightmost stop to about 75%, for example, we see that the last color simply continues, unless we toggle repeating. We get linear repeating, which is controlled by the positioning of the first and last stops. This will still respect the angle we've set. That's a linear gradient. Let's do radial gradients. Here's a different section. This one also has content. Let's select it and go down again to add a gradient. This time, we'll select radial. And two things here to cover before we get started. Number one, the center color, the color at the center of the radial gradient, is the one we see in our gradient preview to the left. And number two, moving the focal point will set the position of that focal point in the radial gradient. But the fade type is controlled by the radius preset. This is one of those times where visually manipulating CSS properties is life-changingly helpful. By default, we have farthest corner. And as we adjust our focal point, the gradient will continue gradating outward until it hits the farthest corner, plain and simple. Closest corner does the same thing, but it stops gradating when it hits the closest corner. Farthest side goes until it hits the farthest side. Closest side, you get the idea. Just like a linear gradient, we can double-click the stops to change color and opacity. And we can add additional stops by clicking underneath the gradient preview. We can still reverse our stops, and we can still toggle repeating. Let's continue to adjust these stops to demonstrate radial repeating. The possibilities here are limitless, but suffice it to say, linear and radial gradients give us the flexibility to create simple or even complex color patterns and fades as background layers.